Well, I've been on my own since I was 15, since my folks died. And I had no brothers or sisters or close kin in that part of the country. So I lit on out of there, and I haven't been back since. You could just call me a tumbleweed blowing in the wind. Well, Rose, I've walked about a mile around this boat deck and chewed over how great the weather's been and how I grew up, but I reckon that's not why you came to talk to me, is it?
Mr. Dawson, I...
Jack?
I want to thank you for what you did. Not just for pulling me back, but for your discretion.
You're welcome.
Look, I know what you must be thinking. Poor little rich girl. What does she know about misery?
No, it's not what I was thinking. What I was thinking was, what could have happened to this girl to make her think she had no way out?
Well, it was everything. It was my whole world and all the people in it. And the inertia of my life. Plunging ahead and me powerless to stop it.
God, look at that thing. You would have gone straight to the bottom.
500 invitations have gone out. All of Philadelphia society will be there. And all the while I feel I'm standing in the middle of a crowded room, screaming at the top of my lungs, and no one even looks up.
Do you love him?
Pardon me?
Do you love him?
You're being very rude. You shouldn't be asking me this.
Well, it's a simple question. Do you love the guy or not?
This is not a suitable conversation.
Why can't you just answer the question?
This is absurd. You don't know me, and I don't know you, and we are not having this conversation at all. You are rude and uncouth and presumptuous, and I am leaving now. Jack, Mr. Dawson, it's been a pleasure. I sought you out to thank you, and now I have thanked you.
And you've insulted me.
Well, you deserved it.
Right.
Right.
I thought you were leaving.
I am. You are so annoying. Wait, I don't have to leave. This is my part of the ship. You leave.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. Well, well, well. Now who's being rude?
What is this stupid thing you're carrying around? So what are you, an artist or something? Well, these are rather good. They're very good, actually. Jack, this is exquisite work.
They didn't think too much of him in old Paris.
Paris? You do get around for a person of limited
Go
means.
Go on, a poor guy, you can say it.
Well. And these were drawn from life?
Well, that's one of the good things about Paris. Lots of girls willing to take their clothes off.
You liked this woman. You used her several times.
Well, she had beautiful hands, you see?
I think you must have had a love affair with her.
No. Just with her hands. She was a one-legged prostitute. See? She had a good sense of humor, though. Oh, and this lady. She used to sit at this bar every night, wearing every piece of jewelry she owned, just waiting for her long-lost love.
Called her Madame Bijou. See, her clothes are all moth-eaten.
Well, you have a gift, Jack. You do. You see people.
I see you.
And?
he wouldn't have jumped.
Well, after that, I worked on a squid boat in Monterey. Then I went down to Los Angeles to the pier in Santa Monica and started doing portraits there for 10 cents a piece.
Why can't I be like you, Jack? Just head out for the horizon whenever I feel like it. Say we'll go there sometime, to that pier. Even if we only ever just talk about it.
No, we'll do it. We'll drink cheap beer. We'll ride on the roller coaster till we throw up. Then we'll ride horses on the beach, right in the surf. Now, but you'll have to do it like a real cowboy, none of that side saddle stuff.
You mean one leg on each side?
Yeah.
Can you show me?
Sure, if you like.
Teach me to ride like a man.
And chew tobacco like a man.
And spit like a man.
What, they didn't teach you that in finishing school?
No.
Well, come on, I'll show you. Let's do it.
What?
I'll show you how. Come
no.
on.
Jack!
Oh, come
no,
on.
Jack! Come on. No! Wait, Jack!
Come on.
No, Jack, come I couldn't on. Possibly, Jack.
Watch closely.
That's disgusting!
All right, your turn. That was pitiful. Come on, you really gotta hock it back, you know? Get some leverage to it. Use your arms. Arc your neck. Now you see the range on that thing?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, go. Oh, that was better. You gotta work on it.
Really?
Really try and hock it up and get some body to it, you know? You gotta...
Mother! May I introduce Jack Dawson?
Charmed, I'm sure. The others were gracious and curious about the man who'd saved my life.